But let's continue our conversation that we just had with Dane Rosenbaum about the kid who was cussing on Snapchat, got in trouble, but the Supreme Court upheld her right to do something. Yeah. As a parent, she would not have that right in our family, but she apparently did it in hers.
How tough is it going to be if we start regulating, you know, the things that kids say on Snapchat
right.
and TikTok and
yeah,
all
would
of
never,
that?
Yeah, and I think
slippery
that's what's
slip.
Going on here. So, Jesse, Jane, what are your thoughts on this particular topic?
Well, I wanted to go a step beyond just what kind of like a kumbaya moment here. I wanted to see why Clarence Thomas dissented. His dissents are
yes.
always fascinating to me. They're not always just what you think it might be. What he was suggesting in his dissent was that it's basically putting schools in a tough position
yep.
because of some speech that is actually detrimental to the good order of the organization. Keep in mind, this girl's, I read what she wrote. It was pretty disgusting.
It was.
And it got back to the coaches. She was using the profanity. And basically an outcry of pretty much upheaval towards the school sports program. And I think the coaches themselves felt like this was really an intimidation. It was also a stirring up controversy, and it impacted those coaches. So we cannot just say it's free speech because it came back to the coaches, and they felt that they had to take action. And I felt the way Clarence Thomas wrote this, he was saying, you know, this is still a little too broad, because the reason it was upheld in the lower courts was that the schools felt that it was impeding their success on campus. So I think that there is some reason to understand why this had to go all the way to the Supreme Court, and that the dissent showed that the schools lose more control now on what impacts them on campus, because
yes,
this
yes.
did get back to campus.
Yeah, Jesse, and to that end, he was saying through social media, speech can be seen and shared on campus. So it doesn't just stay on there, which is 2 years in. And he says, quote, it often will have a greater proximate tendency to harm the school environment than will an off-campus in-person conversation. So you and I can be talking somewhere, we can be having lunch and talking about this or that, is it right? But when you do it on social media, it does get back to the school, which is exactly what you're saying. That was the dissent from Justice Thomas, and I think that's the balance act, is it really does matter. You can't just let kids say anything and everything. So, Derek, your comments here.
Jesse, Jane, thank you for explaining it, because I didn't know why Clarence Thomas, is what his dissent was. But, Bob, I'm with you. Let me handle that as a parent,
yeah.
okay?
Yeah.
Because my daughter, that should be taken care of at the house, at the home. Okay, and so I don't feel like, you know, it should have gotten that far. I understand what you guys just explained, all that kind of stuff, but at some point you have to parent, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And so you need to know, your child needs to know that she cannot go on a rant like that on social media and it be okay. Now, I'm all about the Supreme Court upholding First Amendment and all that kind of free speech, because we need that right now with what we're facing in this country. But that issue right there, that should have been dealt with at home.
Yeah, Amanda?
Well, in Brandenburg v. Ohio in 1969, it was about inciting lawlessness, and
right.
that's where they drew a line on First Amendment rights. So, in other words, you can't go to a movie theater and scream fire. So that's been limited. But how was she inciting violence? I think Justice Breyer's views on this, and really the opinion that he wrote for the majority of the court in an 8-1 ruling, was that, you know, you are, as a school, you're creating future leaders, you're creating future people to go in to talk about this, and whether it's at school board meetings or other places, and people should be allowed their speech. They should be allowed to talk about whatever that they want to within the boundaries that have been created by the Supreme Court. So this was interesting in that it unified 8 members, Democrat and Republican leader, liberal and conservative members of the court on that issue.
Mm-hmm.
And I think they got it right on this, because
yeah.
she was not inciting lawlessness. She was
right.
expressing her views, as gross as they may have been, as unfathomable to some parents as they may have been, they were still her views.
Yeah, and again, it was a balance, because even the majority, even Breyer wasn't saying this was just clean and clear free speech, mm-hmm. say what you want. There is the issue, Heather, of how it affects the school.
Right. Well, she was 14 years old at the time. She did have a statement. She came out with it, and she said, you know, I was 14 years old. I know better now. I saw one of the snaps, and she used a foul four-letter word, begins with an F, softball, bat, whatever, that softball, cheerleading, everything with the foul word in between. You know, so I don't know necessarily if it was a threat, if it was harassment, if it threatened harm, and I think that was significant in saying that as well, even if it was, you know, something that was said off campus. Obviously, as we're discussing, anything online gets back to campus, so it happens there too, but I don't think that it was threatening speech, at least what I saw.
Yeah, we know Merrick Garland, I believe, is also going to appear with President Biden. We don't mm-hmm. know which will come first. Typically, he has an opening act. It's typically Kamala Harris, the vice president, but we're
but
keeping
she might
tabs.
Be headed, no, she's not headed to the border till Friday. That's right.
Right. she's yeah, she's not there yet.
She's
not driving.
Right,
what, Derek?
I didn't know. So she's going to the border. I didn't know that.
Oh, yeah. Breaking news.
Oh, yeah. That's news. She's going to the border, supposedly Friday. We're keeping tabs on President Biden coming out, folks. We need to take a quick break. We'll be back after this.